to try to, so he won't get his elbow up and the choke was over. So I had to adjust.
And did you know you had it in? Because at first it looked like he was almost had an escape, but then he was able. You were able to lock in very tight.
First time was I didn't have it in too tight. He's strong. I'm also strong. I pride myself in being strong, and not only strong, I'm a quick thinker. And he almost turned out of it. But like I said, I'm a good scrambler. I used to fight with the 85ers and the 205ers. So a lot of my training partners is 55ers and 45ers. So I always got to go. So as soon as I felt him get out of it, I had to get back to my knees. And I secured it, and I finished it. I'm the champ, baby.
You said that he was the strongest guy you've ever fought. Would you say that he was also one of the toughest guys you ever fought?
Nah, he wasn't the toughest. He was the strongest. I'm the toughest. I fight myself every day. My sister Ada can beat him all up.
And who do you want? Anybody you want to fight next in the division?
One by one. I don't care. Whoever they give me, I'm gonna beat them down. Me and Alex, we gotta meet eventually. So let's hope he wins tonight. Cause when we meet, it's gonna get nasty. It's gonna get ugly. It's gonna get bloody. I promise.
Kelvin, what's the experience been like fighting here on Long Island at NYCB Live?
I love it. Like a dream come true, man. Madison Square Garden now here, both New York. I love it. See, I was fighting on local shows, making $500 a fight. As soon as I get the $500, $200 going to gas just to get to work. So this is a good feeling. We got a big check. I'm about to go buy me some hot chips and a Pepsi. And I'm about to just relax, take 7 days off. Not really, but that's what they told me to do, so I got to say it on camera. And get back to work. You know what I mean? That's what I'm going to do.
As the competition gets harder, what are you going to do to change your
fight? I took out the two best guys. I feel like that. I already took out the two best guys. So now, I'm the best guy. So now they got to answer to me. But competition ain't going to get harder. I just get better.
What are you going to do in order to get better?
We got some new coaches coming in. Since we got 2.5 months, we got some wrestling coaches coming in. We got some game thing coaches coming in. Just good everywhere. And I don't need a mental coach because I'm already mental. I'm strong. I've been through it all. So that's what we got.
You talked about the longer break moving forward now, but the short break between PFL 1 and tonight, did you like that quick turnaround? Did it work your favor?
I did. I really did like it. Like I said, kept the ball rolling. Kept my training partners, my coaches, everybody was already on it. You know, my guy Keese is cooking my meals for me, meal prepping for me, T-Will. They all do that for me. I don't got to worry about none of that. So as soon as we got home, like, get your butt here, get to practice. I'm like, I don't want to go. And they just make you go. So, like I said, I like the quick turnaround. The 2.5 months will be a lot better because we know what we need to work on. And we see the holes in the game. And we want to get better, and we will get better.
After the last one, you know, you came up with 6 points. You're top of the division tonight. Getting those 5 points. What do you think? You top of the card next time?
I'm on top of the world. What is a card? I'm like way up here. And I'm looking down at everybody now. And I'm just keep going like this to all of them. We're going to keep winning. I ain't going to keep standing, but we're going to keep winning.
What makes you the best heavyweight in the world?
I'm a middleweight. They got a lot of weight on me. We ain't the best in the world yet. Here we are. We got a lot to show. Like I say, I'm good everywhere. I've been through the injuries. People worry about losing. People worry about points. Oh, I got this many points. I don't know how the point system works. I told 20 people that already. I don't know how that works. I just know how to win. That's all I know how to do is win. I ran track. I used to dance. Like, I just want to win. I don't like to lose. I cry if I lose. I cry and I get back to the gym. I work harder and harder and harder. In the gym, I lose every day. I do. These guys, they, my look at him. He's a specimen. Look at that. That boy, he be slamming me on my head. He's strong. My CrossFit coach, you know, and I got guys that beat me up, man. They push me to the limit.
Underdog top of the division, how good does that feel?
How good does what feel?
How good does it feel being an underdog and quitting twice, finishing twice, and being one of the top seeds in the tournament?
I feel like I've been an underdog in life growing up. A lot of people doubted me. So like I say, to be here is a blessing. I feel like I belong here. I ain't gonna let nobody take that away from me, so I feel good about that.
What's the bigger motivation, $1 million or not incurring the wrath of your mother?
Not being poor again. I don't want to be poor again. I don't want to go back to that. I want my kids to have to grow up like we had to grow up. So that's my motivation. I love my mama. I'm going to buy her a nice car and a nice house one day. But my little youngins, they're looking up to me. And just to do something positive without not being in the streets, not robbing, not selling drugs. You know, I didn't graduate high school, so this is, they need to look up to something, and I want to be that man they look up to. I want to be that man that they always come to. So that's what motivates me.
You guys, we're gonna bring Kelvin's obviously mama's boy, so we're gonna bring up Mama Pat for a couple of questions, right? So we can get the real story. And then I think they're hitting the road.
Yeah, we're about to hit the road back.
So just a couple questions, and then they gotta get out of here.
How did it feel to get in the cage after your son's huge win tonight?
Well, first I had to get up in there. Them steps is really hard. You know, and I told that man I can't do it. But once I got in there, it was pretty great.
Were you expecting that? Because that was a pretty special moment for everybody watching and for the fans.
No, I wasn't expecting any of that. They said, we wanted you to say hi to the camera. I said hi to the camera. Next thing I know, he's like, who are you? I'm like, who are you? Kelvin's mom. I'm like, yeah. He said, okay, just stay right here. And there he was. Come get in the cage.
And how did that feel for you to have your mom come up in there and be right next to you with get your hand raised?
Because she don't like climbing up them stairs. It was wonderful. I'm like, oh my gosh, she's climbing up the stairs. Who paid her to come up these stairs?
Right.
But no, it was a good feeling though. I guess she drives to these fights, y'all. 20 hours, she drives. This is the second time out of probably like 10 of my fights where I fought 15, 16, 18, 20 hours that she drove with my coach. She did them by herself. You know, so to be able for her to come and see that and see all of this. This is, to me, this is what it really is. This is what I think this is what makes her proud. Winning is great, but this right here is like I said, we're not used to it. Mm-hmm. We used to live in a one-bedroom apartment, you know, 7 people. So I'm gonna buy a house one day.
Congratulations, you're one step closer to that.
Can you touch on the relationship with your sister?
My sister?
Yeah.
She used to beat me up. What else you want to know? Nah, that's my heart. I love her to death. Everybody say my mom, my biggest fan. I think my mom and my sister, like neck and neck. She kidney failure, right? She got kidney failure, and she goes through it. She's a strong woman. She gets up every day. She take care of her kids. She take care of all of us. She make sure that we good. But one day I might wake up and she like I had to go to the hospital because I'm not feeling good. And I don't like that, so I try to work real hard for her to be able to hopefully be healthy one day, you know what I mean? And but we have a close relationship. She calls me probably every day, bugging me, what are you doing? I'm like, chilling, I guess. Well, can I come see you? I'm like, you know, come on. So we're real close. I'm close to all, I got three older sisters. I'm close to all of them. I talk to them all. We laugh, we joke, we play. We hate each other, we love each other. So like, all my, like I say, I'm the youngest. I got three older sisters. We're all equally close.
At what age did you stop getting beat up by?
I still get beat up by. They don't care about these. Don't care about chokes. They were like, "You my little brother. You do what I say." I like, yes, ma'am. Do whatever. I'll go to the store for you. Get you a Pepsi. Whatever. So yeah, they good. They good to me.
Can you talk about how proud you are of him with his back-to-back wins, and now that he's also at the top of the division?
Well, you know, the thing is, I was proud of him before he ever got a call from PFL. I was proud of him when he was an amateur. I was proud of him when he was on these injuries and not able to fight. So I'm excited and happy that he has this opportunity. But me being proud, the proudness isn't moral. I've always been proud of him. Because he's just basically a good dude, you know. Who raised him?
I'm sorry. Can my coach come up here and you ask him that question? Because this is like my white dad. I love him. this is my man right here. He keep me out of trouble. We the dream team right here. Yeah. Are you proud of me?
Oh, I'm so proud. So proud.
This used to be my karate coach when I was 10. And we moved to Tennessee. And we didn't keep in touch. But I think 8-9 years later, we reconnected. And that was 8 years ago.
Yep.
And then we're here. Hello.
How did ever What did you think when he told you you're going to be an MMA fighter?
Well, let me tell you the story about that. When he was younger, he wanted to play football. You know, he's my baby. He's my only boy. I'm like, boy, you're not playing football. They hit you, I'm going to go fight him, right? So when he turned 18, I was living in Tennessee, and he was up here. When he turned 18, he said, Mom, guess what I'm doing? I'm doing MMA fighting. Like, I didn't know what that was. So when he called me and said, I'm fighting, he's like, I'm doing it. You can't do nothing about it.
So,
He called. I was like 8 hours away, so he didn't tell me face to face.
We didn't have Skype. We had flip phones.
Right. So after that, I'm like, well, because he did a lot of fighting in the streets. So if he gonna do some organized fighting, keep him out of trouble, let him do it.
And eventually, get paid for it. Sign me up.
Hey guys, thanks a lot. Let's let them get on the
road. Thank you.